here's the brief history of Kempton Park. Kempton Park is a main place of Ekurhuleni in the Gauteng province, South Africa. Kempton Park has been part of the city of Ekurhuleni Metropolitan Municipality since 2000. Kempton Park is located on the western city limits of Ekurhuleni and shares its administrative boundaries with Johannesburg, South Africa's largest city. It is situated south of Tembisa, one of the largest townships in South Africa, which is also integrated into Ekurhuleni. The name of the city is sometimes written as Kempton Park in Afrikaans. Kempton Park lies on what was two Boer farms in the South African Republic. The first farm was Zuurfontein number 369, with the title deed issued to Johannes Stephanus Maries. I can't say that name, forgive me if that's your relative. On 25th October 1859, and surveyed to be 3000 Morgan on 12th December 1859. The second farm, northwest of the first, was registered to Cornelius Johannes Bickers in March 1865 and was called Rietfontein 32 IR. After the discovery of gold in Johannesburg, 22 kilometers southeast of the farms, in 1886, a railway connecting Pretoria to Vereeniging and to the Cape Line was constructed in the early 1890s. The railway line did not go through Johannesburg but passed the east through the two farms with a station called Zuurfontein. That station would be linked by a side rail to Zuur Afrikaanske Fabrieken voor onbelofbare stoffen, a dynamite factory a few kilometers northwest. Wow, that's very interesting, eh? Who would have thought? The city was established on 24th of August 1903 when Carl Friedrich Wolff subdivided a portion of his Zuurfontein farm into 216 residential stands and named the new town Kempton after the German town Bavaria of his birth. Wow, okay, wow. You know Bavaria is the birth of BMW.
Oh, really? And some good beer.
Yeah, I mean BMW is the BMW is Bavarian motorworks. Ah, it's interesting. Okay. The name was anglicized into Kempton Park. O.R. Tambo International Airport, Africa's busiest airport, is located in Kempton Park. In 1952, the airport then was known as Jan Smuts International Airport, was built on land next to the community and opened in 1953. The airport's name was changed to Johannesburg International Airport in the late 1990s and then to O.R. Tambo International Airport in 2006. Storming of the Kempton Park World Trade Center. The storming of the Kempton Park World Trade Center took place on 25 June 1993 when approximately 3,000 members of the Afrikaner Force Front AVF, Afrikaner Weerstandsbeweging AWB, and other parliamentary white nationalist Afrikaner groups stormed the World Trade Center in Kempton Park. At the time of the attack, the World Trade Center was the venue for multi-party CODESA negotiations to end the apartheid system through the country's first multi-racial elections. These negotiations were strongly opposed by some white groups in South Africa. The invasion came after other clashes between police and right-wingers, such as the Battle of Ventersdorp and much rhetoric from super-macist such as Eugene Terreblanche of the AWB. Kempton Park has an interesting history.
Kempton Park is a very interesting history. And the great thing is that we are coming into this community, and yet what I find interesting is that one of the biggest entry points to Africa, which is Tambo, is Kempton Park.
Yeah.
And we're literally right across the road from them, across the freight freeway.
Yeah.
So it's quite a significant spot to be in, I think. And there's a history of great musicians that come out from the Kempton Park area, the whole area. Although there doesn't seem to be too much musical activity going on there. So we're coming into a history and starting to revive some things as well. So it's quite interesting. We'll be right back.
Tambo International Airport. This place was established in 1952. Then it was known as the Jansmuts Airport. And in the late 1990s, then the name was changed to Johannesburg International Airport. And then again in 2006, it was renamed after Amoeba Retinal Tambo. Now that's why it is known as the OR Tambo International. It's also the historical site of what has happened during the apartheid regime and throughout the change president. So you can see there from left to right, this tells us all about the history, not all, but part of the history of South Africa.